Hello children, in the last video we read till teachers. Now we will start from soldiers. Soldiers secure our nation from external enemies. What is the meaning of secure? Secure means protect. You know that the soldiers are working day and night to protect the country from the enemies. External means outside. The meaning is already given in your books. The meaning of external is given there. External means outside. So the soldiers are working day and night to protect us from the enemies. A soldier is always ready to die for his nation. We should respect soldiers for what they do for us. They face difficult situations at the border but still do their duty to protect our country. Now see children, we should be very, very thankful to our soldiers, because it is the soldiers due to whom we are surviving. We are safe in our country. Because if soldiers would not be there, obviously our enemies would attack us and we will be no more in this world. So they are the soldiers who are helping us, who are protecting us from the enemies. And we should be very, very thankful to them. And we should respect their work for what they are doing for us and for the sake of the country. And they are standing on the borders day and night, and they are facing difficult situations, but still they are not afraid. They are ready to die for their country. Next is firefighters. Firefighters or firemen are people who put out fire and save people. Like children, about firefighters, I have told you before also in the beginning of the lesson. Like, if somewhere there is fire, who helps in putting out that fire? That is the firefighters. Whenever there is a fire in houses and buildings, firefighters come to the scene and put out fire using large hose pipes of water. Children, the meaning of hose pipes is given there in your books. A flexible tube used for spraying water. So, these firefighters, what do? They come there wherever there is fire and they try to put out the fire using large hose pipes. Hose pipes are very flexible pipes through which they throw water on the place which has caught fire. And they help in saving the lives of the people. They are brave people who face dangers to save us from big fires. And these people are also very brave because they face the dangers of fire and then they are saving the public from the fire. Next is policemen. Policemen help in maintaining law and order in our country. They work day and night to protect us from all dangers. They make us feel safe in our city. Like children, I have told you about soldiers. They are also saving our lives in one way by working day and night on the borders. Similarly, policemen are also working day and night. They help in maintaining law and order in the country. If anybody tries to break the laws, they arrest them. They give them punishment so that that person doesn't repeat all those things again in future. So, in this way, they are helping in maintaining law and order in the country. The traffic policemen in cities control the traffic on roads so that traffic moves smoothly and there are fewer accidents. They also check that people follow the traffic rules while driving their vehicles. Now children, when you go to the market, you must have seen the traffic policemen are managing the traffic. They try to control the traffic jam. So why do they do so? So that there are fewer accidents. The people do not meet any accident while moving from any place. So, and moreover, they also check that the people who are moving on the roads with their vehicles, they are following the traffic rules or not. And if anybody breaks the traffic rules, they punish them. So, the traffic policemen are also there who help in maintaining law and order in the country. Besides the above, there are many other community helpers in our society, like the milkman, sweeper, gardener, security guard, lift man, grocery seller, etc. They all work hard to serve us. Besides all those people, like soldiers, teachers, firefighters, policemen, doctors, nurses, farmers, besides all these people, there are many more community helpers in our society, like the person who is coming to your house in the morning and providing and delivering the milk at your doorstep, the sweeper who is coming to your house to clean the house, the gardener who is taking care of the plants in your garden, security guard, lift man, grocery seller, all these people are also the community helpers who are helping us in our everyday life, and they are working very hard to serve us, to help us. Now let's move on to the next page. Next is special people. Now children, in our society there are some special people. Not the people who are very rich or who are having very big houses or who are like politicians. No, they are not the special people. The special people are those like the old people, the sick people, the differently abled people. All these people are called special people. Now let's read about special people. Our society is made up of different types of people. Some people are special because they need our extra care and love. These include people who are old, sick, needy, and differently abled. Now, in a society, there are different types of people. Some are young, some are old, some are good by health, but some are not good by health. Like some are very sick, some are differently abled, means they are, some are handicapped. Some are blind, some cannot walk, some cannot hear, some cannot speak, some cannot see. So there are differently abled people in a society. So what should we do for them? We should take care of them. Like at your home only, children, your grandfather or grandmother must be there. They are old and you should help them in their old age. Whatever they need, you should obey them. So at this age, they need your help. So you should obviously take care of them. You should obey them. Whatever they need, you should provide them. Whether they need their medicines on time or their food on time, you should do all these things for your grandparents as well as your parents. With age, people grow old. Old people need special care because they are weak or they suffer from some disease. Like with age, everybody is going to grow old better. Like today you are small children, one day will come when you will also grow old. At that time, you will also need the help of some people or some your children, that they also serve you, they also take care of you. Similarly, today you are small, but your grandparents are there at home, your parents are there at home. So you should help them, you should take care of them. At home, we should take special care of old people like our grandparents. Many cities have special old age homes, especially for the old people. Like in many cities, there are old age homes. Like there are some people who throw out their parents out of their homes in their old age. This is very, very bad, children. This is not good at all. Because you just think of that one day, when you will also grow old, if your children will throw you out of the home, then what will you feel at that time? So you should think that our grandparents are our responsibility and we have to take care of them. We have to take special care of them. Some people are poor and do not have enough money to eat healthy food or live in a comfortable house. We should be more kind to such people. Children, in your surroundings only, you can see that there are people who are very poor. And there are some people, many people, not some, but there are many people who don't even have a house of their own. They sleep on the streets. And we should help those people. We should help those people. How? By providing them with healthy food, or we should consult some communities, some social groups, so that we can build up the small houses for them where they can live comfortably. Some people in our society may be sick. They suffer from diseases like cancer, tuberculosis, leprosy, etc. They need special care and attention. Children, there are some people who are sick in a society who are not well. They might be suffering from one or the other illness or one or the other disease like cancer, tuberculosis, leprosy. These are all the different kinds of diseases. So we should also take special care of those people. Like they are, if those people are not able to pay the huge bills of the hospitals, we should consult with a social group so that we can help those people and we can send them to the hospitals for their treatment. Children, the remaining lesson I will explain you in the next video.